Frog and Toad Together. Chapter 5. Final Chapter. The Dream. Toad was asleep, and he was having a dream. He was on a stage, and he was wearing a costume. Toad looked out into the darkness. Frog was sitting in the theater. A strange voice from far away said, "Presenting the greatest toad in all the world." Toad took a deep bow. Frog looked smaller as he shouted, "Hooray for Toad!"
"Toad will now play the piano very well," said the strange voice.
Toad played the piano, and he did not miss a note. "Frog," cried Toad, "can you play the piano like this?"
"No," said Frog.
It seemed to Toad that Frog looked even smaller.
"Toad will now walk on a high wire, and he will not fall down," said the voice.
Toad walked on the high wire. "Frog," cried Toad, "can you do tricks like this?"
"No," peeped Frog, who looked
very, very small.
"Toad will now dance, and he will be wonderful," said the voice.
"Frog, can you be as wonderful as this?" said Toad, as he danced all over the stage. There was no answer. Toad looked out into theater. Frog was so small that he could not be seen or heard. "Frog," said Toad, "where are you?" There was still no answer.
"Frog, what have I done?" cried Toad.
Then the voice said,
"The greatest toad will now..."
"Shut up!" cried Toad.
"Frog, Frog, where have you gone?"
Toad was spinning in the dark.
"Come back, Frog," he shouted. "I will be lonely."
"I am right here," said Frog. Frog was standing near Toad's bed. "Wake up, Toad," he said.
"Frog, is that really you?" said Toad.
"Of course it's me," said Frog. "And are you your right size?" asked Toad.
"Yes, I think so," said Frog.
Toad looked at the sunshine coming through the window. "Frog," he said, "I am glad that you came over."
"I always do," said Frog.
Then Frog and Toad ate a big breakfast, and after that, they spent a fine, long day together. I hope you enjoyed Chapter 5 and Frog and Toad Together.